Hello, I'm Bharat Sivaraman, Senior Program Manager for Azure Site Recovery. In this video, I'll show you some of the recent enhancements we've made to help you monitor and troubleshoot Azure Site Recovery. We'll start out by looking at the new Azure Site Recovery dashboard that's part of the Vault Overview page. We'll then explore the contents of the dashboard, focusing specifically on the following parts: the Replication Health Overview, the Test Failover Status Overview, the Configuration Issues section, the Error Summary section, and then finally, we look at the all-new infrastructure view that is part of this dashboard. We'll see how these parts come together to help you monitor Azure Site Recovery. So let's jump into a quick demo. The first thing I notice when I select a Recovery Services Vault on the Azure portal is the Vault Overview page. A toggle switch lets me select between Azure Backup and Azure Site Recovery. Selecting Azure Site Recovery takes me to the Azure Site Recovery dashboard. This dashboard summarizes all the information I need to understand if my business continuity objectives are being met. Let us explore the dashboard to see what information it contains. The replicated items donut at the top left of the dashboard gives me an overview of the replication health of my protected servers. This donut, for example, tells me that I have 9 protected servers in this vault. Of these, replication is healthy for 8 of the protected servers, but there is one server for which the replication health is currently critical. I can see a list of servers based on their current replication health by clicking the appropriate category. For example, clicking critical shows me the list of servers with critical replication error symptoms. I can then drill down further into one of the impacted servers or look at the associated replication error symptoms to understand how I can nurse replication for the server back to a healthy state. One cannot stress enough the importance of performing periodic disaster recovery drills. A DR drill is the best way to validate the capability of your business continuity plan and to ensure that your business continuity objectives are being met. Azure Site Recovery's test failover feature gives you a non-disruptive way to test failover of your servers and applications to an isolated environment, thereby helping you evaluate your business continuity preparedness. The failover test success donut shows me how many of my protected servers have never had a successful test failover and recommends that I schedule a test failover for these servers. It also shows me a count of the servers that have had one or more successful test failovers and a count of servers such as failover servers for which test failover is not applicable currently. Clicking Test Recommended shows me a list of servers that have never had a successful test failover. I can then schedule a test failover for these servers, or alternatively, schedule a test failover for a recovery plan containing these servers. The Configuration Issues section of the dashboard tells me if there are configuration-related issues that may impact my ability to failover replicating servers to Azure. It also tells me how I can remediate any such issue. This is also the section from where I get notified about the availability of Azure Site Recovery software updates. Now, looking at the configuration issues listed here, I see that I seem to have a subscription quota related issue. Looking at this, I see that I'm under provisioned in my subscription in terms of available CPU cores that I'll require to fail over all the replicated servers in this vault at once. This is easy to address. All I need to do is call up Azure support and have my core quota increased. I also see that one of my protected servers is missing some configuration. Looking at the target configuration issues for the server, I find out that I haven't configured a recovery network for the server yet. Again, this is easily addressable by updating the recovery network settings for this server. By being able to identify such configuration-related issues upfront, I am able to address them proactively as opposed to having to react during a failover situation, thereby minimizing the RTO or the recovery time objective that I'm able to achieve. The replicated items donut shows me how many of my servers are facing replication issues. But in order to understand what is impacting replication, I go to the error summary section of the dashboard. The error summary section shows the list of error symptoms or replication errors currently impacting the protected servers in this vault and the count of servers impacted by each error. In this case, I have one server that is critical, and this server seems to be showing multiple replication error symptoms. Looking at the list of errors, I see that this server is unable to communicate with the process server used for replication, and as a result, doesn't have a recent enough recovery point that I can fail over to. Clicking the error gives me more information on the impacted servers due to each error and recommendations on how to remediate the error. The infrastructure view is a visual map of your disaster recovery setup. The view tells me, based on my source environment, things such as how many servers I have currently replicating to Azure, how many Azure storage accounts am I replicating these servers into, how are these servers connected up to the Azure storage account, how is replication data being plumbed into these Azure storage accounts, etc. Not only does the view show me the various components and artifacts involved in replication, but it also shows me the health of the connectivity between these components. The infrastructure view gives me an easy way, and one that scales with my deployment, to help me understand how my DR setup is operating currently. I can also drill down into this view and scope it to a single replicating server. The replicated item details page gives me very detailed insights that help me understand how replication for a particular server is progressing currently. Not just that, I can also see the recent history for this replicating server. With all these insights that are now available to me, I'm able to get in-depth visibility into how my systems are operating from a business continuity preparedness perspective, and I'm able to easily troubleshoot and remediate anything that hampers my ability to meet my business continuity objectives. So, to recap, in this video, we first saw what the new Azure Site Recovery Vault dashboard looks like. We then looked at the various parts of the dashboard, such as the replication health summary, the test failover status summary, the configuration issues section, the error summary section, and the infrastructure view, and saw how these pieces can be used to understand deeply your current DR posture and improve it as needed. I hope you found the information in this video useful. Thank you for watching.